Hi, morning everyone. Happy Monday morning. Fundraising day for RADARS. That's children and families with learning or physical difficulties, local here in town in LA. Fantastic. Anyhow, back onto the matter of hand. The sun, the definition of the sun. You see, lovely little card, looks very happy. And generally meaning, okay, it's quite an easy one to remember because it means growth. Now, that's all relative to what it's next to. So if you've got it next to deception or disruption, it's growth of deception or disruption. I mean, generally speaking, it's a good card. Generally, it comes up to next to a relationship or your energy levels or creativity. And you get the sun next to it, it means growth. You might have it up next to a business interest or financial query, it means growth. So good. But if it's next to some bad cards, it means the bad situation's also growing. All right, I got to dash because I got to go make some rice for this charity lunch thing.
Hope you guys everyone. It's Thursday morning today, and today we have 7 and 8.
I have to show these two together. Hello. I have to show these two together because we're over here. Stop moving. Because the chariot and strength actually mean the same thing. To the experienced tarot reader, they mean winning through or victory. It's just for you and I, the experienced tarot reader, this is one type of person, and this is another type of person. So let's start with number 7. So we know the meanings of these cards are the same, victory and winning through. Okay, so let's start with number 7. That's chariot. Can't get used to this webcam. The chariot person will come into a room and go, right, I want to know, is my house going to sell? Yes or no? Give it to me straight. Maybe not that extreme, but they're very black and white. The end justifies the mean. Get to the point. Bottom line. Boom, boom, boom. Don't pussyfoot around it. Okay? So when this comes up in a spread, we know this person's going to be victorious or win through because morally they feel convicted. You see the two sphinxes, black and white? Just remember that. These people are very black and white, so give it to them straight. Now we get to lovely number 8. Notice my voice has changed because lovely number 8, strength. You see, she's got infinity on the top of her head. She's stroking the line with the mouth open. She is gentle. She or he is the type of person that would come in and have a reading and go, please tell me, is everything going to be okay? I really don't know what to do. I don't want to hurt anyone. So they're terribly kind, lovely people who wouldn't harm a fly. They're always thinking of other people's feelings first. But you need to be a bit more gentle in how you present your facts to these people. You need to be kinder. You need to think about how it would sound. And it's interesting because a lot of times students ask me, oh God, here we go, get in the frame, which one's right, which one's wrong? And I say to people, neither of these people is right or wrong. They both just have a certain way of presenting their situation. They have a certain way of dealing with it. The chariot wants things done, over and out, quick response. And the strength individual just wants to take their time and make sure something works out all right without people getting hurt. Neither is right, neither is wrong. You just get two different types of people. Both means winning through and, you know, justice and that type of thing. But just different how they get it out, if you follow me, how they communicate. On a different note, the good news is my latest cockerel, and his name is Boise, named after my mate Katie's dog. He cock-a-doodle-dooed 5 times today. How cool is that? He's a Cochin, and he's a big fella. And I nearly spilled the coffee. And he has...
They wanna see hate like you lean on your face. I think there's something in to a game.